cook in here. I always have a Red Bull in here. But, they're making a stuffed pork tenderloin. We got the bacon right there. We got some spinach. We got onions in the pan right there. Already, I didn't want to bore you all with the boring stuff. So I got a lot of this stuff ready. We got cheese in the fridge too that we're going to be putting on it. Cream cheese, everything. So I already did most of the prep work on this. Now I'm going to cut it open. Nice. Slit. And then I wanna open it. Come back through. And make sure you stay on the same cut so you get it cut just right. Because you don't want it too thin and you don't want it too thick. So you like the more you come through, you get to open her up. See how she's opening? And they like, and then come back through right there. Do the same exact thing. And if you keep that going, you basically want it like an inch and a inch ish. And you just keep opening it. Like this one, I can keep coming because right it is still thick. So come back. Oops. I cut through that, but that don't mean nothing. That don't matter. Because it's going to be rolled back. So you want it just like that. Wash the hands, you know, because I gotta be touching other things. Wash the hands. Move it to the fridge. Waste cream cheese. Oh, I already got the cream cheese out. You see that? You see that? I already got the cream cheese out. And
that's why you need an assistant.
And that's why I needed Mistress Mass Randomness here to help me out with this. So what I'm going to do... Always got to go with the Philadelphia. You don't go with Philadelphia, I don't want the cream cheese. It's already soft. Yeah. See, Bob's Random Cooking, I don't measure, I just do. And what I do is what I do. I destroyed this package. Take the back end of the spoon. Take that soft cream cheese. Whoops. You want it on the meat, not the cutting board. But I'm not going to use a spoon on that. So I'm going to use a clean knife. Actually, you know what? This might work a little better. Throw that in there to wash. Take it. Take a little more. And you just... want to spread it. Oh, well, whatever. I'll throw this away. I'll eat it one way or the other. I don't care. You just want to make sure you get the cream cheese on it. These bags suck. Yeah, I did. I don't have a grater. And I. So I had to go this way. You want to take cheese, sprinkle it on like that. So you cover it. Evenly. Just like that. Alright. A little bit more right up there. A little more there. A little bit everywhere. Because you cannot get sick of cheese. Cheese is good. That over there, right? Take this. You can go like that if you want to pat it down. But you take your spinach. Spinach is good. Spinach! Bang. You just want one layer of spinach. Well, I don't mind spinach, so. And you just cover it like that. One more right there because I didn't like that hole. All right. Now the best part. Oh yeah.
This is before the best part.
And now you take red onions and garlic. just like that. Doesn't have to be perfect, but spread it out. Now, I'm gonna be using that because I have to saute this for about 6 to 8 minutes. 2 minutes per side. There's gonna be four sides. 2 minutes per side, so 8 minutes. Put that there. So now, I know I had to get that out of the way. So now you take the bacon bits.
That's the best part.
Bacon bits right there, right? Sprinkle these bacon bits that I made. Yeah, I made them big because I like my bacon big. I want to taste my bacon. And you sprinkle it all over till it's all on there. That makes sense. Yeah. Over there. Oh, just so everybody knows, I use balsamic vinegar in with the onions when I saute the onions in the bacon fat with 2 tablespoons of butter. A little accident in the kitchen. See, Red Bull gave me wings. So, now that we got these pre-cut, I'm going to have to cut them again. But what I want to do is, I'm not going to bore you. I'm going to show you once. I'm going to pause it and I'm going to do it and I'll come back. So you take it and you run it underneath just like you're flossing. Just like you're flossing. So there's one, two. You're going to need about 5. So I cut 5. Right, so come in this way, and that's good right there, that's good there, and this last one right there. So now you got all of them ready to go. So when you roll it, you don't have to deal with it with one hand trying to feed the string. So, just like you're rolling, you wanna start rolling. And when you get in there, you wanna roll up, up. You wanna pull up. You don't wanna push down on it. Roll up, roll up. Roll up. Make sure you get the strings lined up, right? And eventually, you'll get to this position, right there. Now you take the bacon twine. And you tie knots on it. I'm going to tie the rest of these knots and I'll be back with you moment shortly. We got the pan on it right there on medium. I got the oil in there, the bacon. So what I want to do is put this down like that. I want to blend it, like kind of like blend it. You want to do it 2 minutes per side. So 2 minutes this way, 2 minutes on this side, 2 minutes on that side, 2 minutes on that side. You don't want no more than 8 minutes, 6 to 8 minutes. Like, depending on how it cooks, you don't really need to go the full 2 minutes. You just basically want to like stop cooking it. Like, you don't want it to cook, and you don't want it to stick near. Right? So, within 2 minutes, I'll be back and I'll show you. Well, maybe not in 2 minutes. I'll be back to show you before I flip it over on the last side what it should look like.
What's the oven supposed to be on?
400. See, that's basically what you want to do.
Yeah, you're just searing it.
Yep. And it's on for 400?
I want to turn that side, babe.
No, that was the side that I needed to actually drill more. That's all this is. I need all that stuff out of here so I can scrub this thing real quick. So basically you want it to look like that, not like that. So keep it like this. I'm gonna grab the hand for it to go in. And again, sponsor for all my videos because I drink Red Bull all the time. Red Bull is my crack cocaine. It's my energy. It keeps me going. It gives you wings. So, you want to keep it going like that. That's good right there. Like, that's good right there. Because it's going in the oven. And it's going to bake. Give or take. 20 minutes. You want it to be at least 145. Is good, like good cooking for pork. Don't mind if you get a little pink. A little bit of pink and pork don't hurt you as long as it's cooked to the internal temperature of 145. And like some people even say not over 150 for something like this. So now, like you can see how that's starting to turn like that. So give it like another 30 seconds and then I'm going to transplant it in there. And then when that reaches 400, then I will put it in the oven. You know, set the timer for 20 minutes, but it could be a half hour. It all depends on internal temperature at the thickest part. So right there is where I want to stick it. Right there. Or wherever the thickest part is. Look at all that. Look at that melting. Oh my God, that's going to be so good. Like, honestly, this is good right now. So I'm going to just shut the heat off. And I'm going to take it out of this. And I got it ready. I want the top side up. That side I want up, right? That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna add a little Montreal steak seasoning to pork. Yeah, steak seasoning. I said it. Steak seasoning goes good with pork and fish. Yay, yay. I love my seafood, by the way. I got myself some shrimp to go with it. Yeah, that's how I roll. I love my seafood. So, for this, I'm only gonna sprinkle some on the top. That's about it. I don't measure my stuff. My stuff's never measured. I go by eyeball to taste. So, we got a couple more minutes. We'll be back right before we put it in the oven. We got the oven set to 400. So we're going to put this in. Middle of the rack. Cooking time. 20 minutes.
Start.
Start. So now in 20 minutes, or when it's ready, I'll come and I'll show you what it looks like. There may be a part two. Because I want the ink to, whatever you call that thing, when, like, you're waiting to see what the results come out like. Yeah, I got a bad memory. I forget words sometimes when I'm talking, because that's how I do it. Because you want to know why? I blame Red Bull for that. Mm-hmm. That's why I say Red Bull should sponsor me. I'll be back.
Alright. So, now... And that says, end. So, I'll just leave that right there for right now. Come down here. Jake, this is bad, Larry. put it down there, right? Now we already got that. It says beef, but I know what the internal temperature is supposed to be, so I want to go with the fattest part right there. Stick it in. I want it to be at least 145. It says 138 there. That one says 144. Come over here. 153. Right there. 149. Well, it's cooling off, but that's done. So I'm gonna just let that sit for about 10 minutes. All right, I'll let that sit for 10 minutes and I'll be back.